And take another breath. And bring your energy inside. Let each breath bring life force into your being, into your body, into your heart. Let it in and out so that the breath becomes a wave of life force and love coming and going, washing over you, each one of us a drop in an ocean of waves, feeling the love wash that Kryon and the entourage has in the room. Feeling the circle of love that draws us all together and being held in that circle with honor.
Greetings, dear ones. I'm Kryon of Magnetic Service. Indeed, this is the first message in the year of the One. And 2017 is going to be packed with potential change. Only the kinds of changes you may see and the catalysts that are here are not necessarily what you saw in the last few years. I'm going to say to you on this day, if you watch your news, you will not believe anything I'm going to tell you. And that is because the world in 3D, a world that looks at only negative things, will depress you and put you into a state of negativity and fear. And I want to warn those who are listening that this particular attribute will not improve, not this year. In other words, light workers, old souls, you're going to have to be circumspect. What is happening on the planet is more than what you see on the television. There is so much going on here. The shift is here. It's not coming, it's here. And all of these years since 2012 and the end of 2012 have been you calibrating so that you can arrive at the year of the One and rebuild and understand. There are those who've never heard Kryon. Some who are listening to this recording for the first time, you've never heard Kryon. And there's always the question, what is this? Who is this? Could this be real? And so I'll say what I always do. I invite you to tune in to the compassion and the love of God. There is nothing in this message that is fearful. It is always something to celebrate the human being and the state that you're in, and what is going on and what you've been through. It celebrates prophecies of thousands of years. This is not the new age. This is now an age that has been prophesied to be. This is an energy that always was coming if you would allow it, and you did. It's not new. It contains the seeds of the ancient knowledge right from the dirt of the earth, right from the stars. Is it too much for you to sit and be loved by the creator of the universe, is it too much to consider no strings attached? Is it too much for there not to be a doctrine or someone to worship? Is it too much for you? All of those things, dear ones, are appropriate to get in touch. But right now, I ask you, is it too much for you to be known by God? Every soul in this room is eternal. If you want to look at the messages of the masters, there is life after death. And if you want to look at what the ancients taught, there's life after life after life. You are eternal, known by God, loved by God. All of the things that you came with are known. Your innate rings with this. You're in a group of support. Even if you don't know the other person next to you, if you never know their names, I'll tell you there is an alliance here. And the alliance is love, and it's compassion for one another as you move through difficult times. Because you're the lighthouses. There will be those who will come to you in the next days. They're going to be say, I'm afraid. I don't know what's going on. The direction of my country, the direction of the world, what's just happened. And what are you going to say? Are you going to join them in fear? Or are you going to stand tall and say, I know it looks bad, but there's something bigger you should know. There's a real shift going on the planet, and it was prophesied. And it has to do with the future of the earth. And what happens when low consciousness starts to change into something a bit higher? Did you ever think for a moment, old soul, that if you just sat there long enough, everybody would be just fine? This takes work. And if you think that perhaps a big stick has been put into everything and stirred vigorously, you're right. And the reason is because what happens next is an offshoot of a wild card, unexpected things, things you never thought perhaps could ever happen, and some of them very benevolent. But you got to wade through the mud in order to get to the other side. The good news is all around you. You've got the equipment, you've got the tools. An old soul sits in front of me. This may be the first time you've ever come to a meeting like this. I know who's here. You may be wondering what the real message is. Can't you feel it? This is your time. You may know nothing about this, never heard cry on. Can't you feel it? Something's up. There's something beautiful in all of this. And I'll tell you what it is. It's you. It starts here. Your reaction to other people in fear, your guidance, your mastery. How you become calm. How you react to things that in the past made you crazy. All of these things are starting to shift. And the beauty really is in you. I'm not speaking to one room filled with people. I and the others like myself who will be channeling this weekend are talking to old souls. There's tens of millions of you all over the planet. When I sat on a stage in Tel Aviv And my partner had brought me to the chair. And what I told them, in the center of the turmoil, that color was going to come to a black and white society. I was speaking to 1,000 old souls and light workers right in the middle of a place that on your news says there's no hope. And on your news says it's only trouble. Only bad things happen there. Just take a look at the news. When's the last time you heard of a wonderful, joyous, compassionate thing happening there? And I'll tell you, there are things in the works there that'll make you weep with joy. And you'll see it's coming. It's changing. There are things coming nobody expects. Solutions that will make sense and that are hard, and it'll come right out of the community in that small little country. Not from the West. Things are different than you think. Things are not exactly as they seem. Can you hold that light and not know the facts of what they are? Can you feel it? There's a reason for this season here. I want you to feel the love and compassion for you, the seed inside you that never dies, the soul that is connected to the Creator. Oh, there's a veil there. And that's the mystery. Because it's not totally revealed to you. But what is the love. You can feel it. And I'll say it again. Does it bother you to be loved unconditionally by the creative source without you having to perform? Get used to it. It's even involved in your physics on this planet. Benevolence is going to be more than you think. Don't leave this place in fear. There's so much to celebrate in the year of the One. And so it is.